So now try to solve these questions. A list of release and the power system components protected by the release are given in list 1 and list 2 respectively. Choose the correct match out of the 4 choices given below. Okay, that is the question. So distance relay, where do we use the distance relay?
Transmission lines.
Transmission lines. Okay. So distance relay we use for the transmission lines. A differential relay where we use? Or first go to the Buchholz relay. Buchholz relay is only used for
transformers.
Yeah. Distance relay is only used for transmission lines. Okay.
So option A.
So the other choices would be differential relay. We can use for transformers, generators, bus bars.
Alternators.
But you have to go by choices. Under frequency relay, you only use it for the alternators. There is no other location where we use this one. So the differential relay, we can use it for the bus bars. Okay. Understand. So this is the option. So which is the right option? D1. A is the right option. First option is the right option. Understand? Yeah, there are differential relay we can use for transformers, bus bars, alternators and motors as well. But depending upon the other choices, the option boils down to option A. Now look at the second question. The transmission line distance protection relay that is having inherently directional feature. Which relay is inherently directional? Which relay is inherently directional? More relay is inherently directional. Understand? It is the only relay which is inherently directional, whereas all other relay, that is impedance relay, reactance relay and ohm relay, are all the following. So short transmission lines, we use which relay?
Reactance relay.
Medium transmission lines?
Option A.
Ohm relay or impedance relay, both are same. Impedance relay, okay. So medium transmission line, we use impedance relay. Long transmission line, we use more relay. Okay. So which is the right option? The right option. Understand. So which one of the following relays, not replace, it's a print mistake. Which one of the following relays has the capability of anticipating the possible major fault in the transformer? It is the relay that is anticipating before the occurrence of the major fault. What is that relay? Buchholz relay is a relay that acts before the major fault because it detects the slowly developing faults. So Buchholz relay is the relay that anticipates the possible major fault in the transformer. So the relay is given, the relay operating characteristics are given. So what is the relay he is asking? These operating characteristics are for which relay?
More relay.
They are for the more relay. Understand? Match the following again. Negative sequence relay. Where we use negative sequence relay? For
rotor
protection of alternators. For rotor protection of alternators. Understand? So harmonic restraint differential relay. So harmonic restraint differential relay is used in transformer protection. Okay. So it is a distance relay with additional harmonic restraint feature to prevent a nuisance tripping or mal tripping during inrush currents. So we use harmonic restraints differential relay for transformer protection. More relay, where we use? More relay we use for the long transmission lines. We use more relay for the long transmission lines. Understand? Long transmission lines, we use more relay. Okay. Next, overcurrent relay with a time delay is used in the distribution feeder protection. Distribution feeder protection. Understand? So negative sequence relay is used for the protection of rotor in alternators. Harmonic restraint differential relay is used for the transformer protection. More relay is used for the protection of long high voltage transmission lines. Overcurrent relay with the time delay is used for the distributor feeder protection. So which is the right option? Is the right option. Understood. So a Buchholz relay is used for the which is the right option?
Transformer against internal faults.
Internal faults.
Protection of transformer against internal faults. It only protects against the internal faults. Undervoltage relays are mainly used for it is used for transformer, transmission line and motor protection. All the above is the right option. Understand? Undervoltage relays are mainly used for all the equipment. So which is the main relay for protecting 90% of transmission line length in the forward direction? So out of these relays, which relay protects the 90% of the transmission line in the forward direction? So more relay is the relay that protects the 90% of the transmission line in forward direction, because it occupies least space and it can handle power swings very well. So more relay protects the 90% of the transmission line length in the forward direction. Okay. The inverse definite minimum time feature in electromagnetic type overcurrent relay, the minimum time feature is achieved because of. So what decides that minimum time feature in the this one? So that minimum time is decided by the saturation of the magnetic circuit. So if the CT saturates, then what will happen? You will get the definite minimum time feature. If CT is not saturated, then if current increases, what will happen? Your time keeps on decreasing. Understand? So once the CT saturates, the operating time becomes more or less constant. How many relays are required to detect interface fault of the three-phase system? So in a three-phase system, to detect any overcurrent and short circuit fault, to detect all types of interface faults. Three relays are sufficient. Out of which, two are overcurrent relays, and one is
earth fault relay.
So, for three-phase system, the minimum three relays are required to completely protect against the short circuit and earth faults. That is the question. Minimum is three. Option C is the right option. In a three-phase distance protection, the reach of three zones of relay at the beginning of the first line typically extends up to. So in a three-phase distance protection, the reach of the three zones of the relay at the beginning of the first line typically extends up to. So suppose this is a two adjacent lines. If I draw like this, this is one line. Let us call this line as AB. AB C. Suppose these are the relays. He's asking what is the zone of the first relay. Let us call this as R1. So what are the zones here? The zone of this relay is 80% of the first line. This is high speed zone. Next, what you have? 20% of this line and 20% of the adjacent line. The remaining is 30% of this one. So basically, it is 80%, 120%, and 150% from the relay. So which is the nearest option out of all? So 80% of first line, 20% of second line, and 10% of the third line. Understand? So option C is the nearest option, because what is the zone 1? Zone 1 is 80% of first line. So in zone 2, 20% of second line is there. And in zone 3, usually 10% of the third line will come. Understand? That is the feature. So the appropriate option is the C is the right option. Now this is one question. Consider the problem of relay coordination for distance relays R1 and R2 on adjacent lines of the transmission system. The zone 1 and zone 2 settings of both relays are indicated on the diagram. Which of the following indicates the correct time setting for the zone 2 of relay R1 and R2? So in this figure, he is showing the zone 1 and zone 2 of relay R1, zone 1 and zone 2 of relay R2. So for proper relay coordination, he is asking what should be the time settings of zone 2 of relay R1 and R2. Okay. So here, the zone 2 of R1 is this one. The zone 2 of R1 is this one. Okay. Whereas the zone 2 of R2 is this one. Okay. So, for proper relay coordination, it should happen that both the zone 2 time settings of relay R1 and R2 should be same. C is the right option. Because since this region, zone 2 region, should have some time delay, and even for relay R2, the zone 2 region should have some time delay. The time delay should be such that both time delays for zone 2 of relay R1 and R2 should be same. Understand? Suppose had he asked the zone 2 of relay R1 and zone 3 of relay R1 and zone 2 of relay R2, then there should be some discrimination. Then the option A would have been right option. Since he is asking the correct time setting of zone 2 of relay R1 and R2, so zone 2 of relay R1 and R2 should be such that both should be having 0.3 same time delay. 0.3 time delay. Understood? In the protection of transformer, harmonic restraint relay is used to guard against in the protection of transformer, harmonic restraint is used to guard against what? Magnetic inrush currents. Magnetic inrush currents. Understand? So read the next question and try to understand what he is asking. Read the next question. So here image is missing. I'll draw the image. In a two machine power system as shown below, the transmission line XY, has a positive sequence impedance of Z1 and a zero sequence impedance of Z0. On phase A to ground fault with zero fault impedance occurs at the center of transmission line. Suppose if the LG fault occurs at this point, phase A to ground fault with zero fault impedance occurs at the center of transmission line. So this is bus bar X and bus bar Y. The bus voltage at X and line current from X to F for phase A are given by what? The voltage of this bus is VA. The fault current flowing through bus, this bus is IA. Respectively, then the impedance measured by the ground distance relay located at terminal X of the line will be given by. So he's simply telling, two machine power system is as shown in the figure and it is connected by a transmission line X and Y. Okay. So he has given the zero sequence impedance of the line as Z1 ohm and the positive and zero sequence impedance of the transmission line are given by these values. So during fault, the voltage of bus X is VA and current through bus X is IA. Suppose if a distance relay is connected at this point at bus X, so what is the impedance measured by the ground distance relay located at terminal X of the line XY will be given by what this one. So he's simply testing what is the impedance seen by the relay. Impedance seen by the relay is the value of voltage at the relay location divided by current through the relay at the relay location. So the option would become D is the right option. Because now relay is seeing a voltage of VA at the bus bar X and the current through the bus bar during fault is IA. So impedance seen by the relay is given by voltage at the relay location divided by the current through relay CT. Understand? So impedance seen by the relay, is voltage at relay location divided by current through relay. That is the point. So simply is misleading by giving the unnecessary data. The option is VA divided by IA. The plug setting of negative sequence relay is 0.2. So here plug setting means pickup current, or you can say 0.2 ampere. The CT ratio is 5:1. The minimum value of line to line fault current, for the operation of relay is. Okay. So here suppose three lines are there. Okay. The negative sequence relay is connected in, suppose this line with the CT of this one. So this relay R is the negative sequence relay. This CT ratio is 5:1. The pickup current of relay is 0.2 ampere. Now what should be the minimum line to line fault current? Such that the relay operates. That is the question. So suppose if the line to line fault current is IL or IF. Okay, let the line-to-line fault current is IF. Now, what is the current flowing through this one? So, IF, for a line-to-line fault, the fault current is given by what? Root 3 into IA1 or root 3 into IA2. Understand? So, the current flowing through the line, if this is the current, this value of current will be how much? IF divided by root 3. Fault current divided by root. Okay. Now, what is the current flowing through the CT? Current through relay, that is equals to IR is equals to fault current divided by root 3 divided by what is the CT ratio? 5:1. Okay. So, this value will become IF divided by 5 root 3. This should be minimum, should be equal to pickup current for relay operation. This should be minimum equal to pickup current for relay operation. So, if you equate this, what should be your fault current? Your fault current will become minimum fault current at which the relay is on the verge of operation is 5 root 3 into 0.2, whose answer is root 3 ampere. Root 3 ampere. So, if the line-to-line fault occurs, then your fault current is given by root 3 into IA1 or root 3 into IA2. Understand? So, in this case, because all overcurrent relays operate on positive sequence components or positive or negative sequence components only, here IA2, negative sequence component of current IA2 is given by what? IA2 is given by IF by root 3. So, IF by root 3 will become this one. So, what is the current through relay? IF by root 3 divided by what is the CT ratio? 5:1. So, if this current through relay is minimum equal to pickup value, then only the relay is on the verge of operation. So, he's asking the minimum value of line-to-line fault current at which the relay is on the verge of operation. This value will become IF is equal to 5 root 3 into 0.2, that is root 3 ampere. Understand? Here the crux is negative sequence relay operates on negative sequence currents, that is IA2. Negative sequence current, that is IA2. So IA2 magnitude is given by, in a line-to-line fault, IF is equals to root 3 IA1 or root 3 IA2. So from this, IA2 value is given by what? IF divided by root 3. That is equals to IA2, negative sequence current. Understand? So now CT ratio is 5:1 and relay pickup current is 0.2. If you equate the relay current equal to pickup current, it is on the verge of operation. So the minimum fault current that is required is root 3 ampere. Understand? To prevent the maloperation of differentially connected relay while energizing the transformer, the relay restraining coil is biased with. So, to prevent the maloperation of differential relay connected to the transformer during charging, the relay restraining coil is biased with which component of current? Second harmonic of current. Because here we pass the second harmonic current through the restraining coil to provide additional restraining force, which will prevent the operation of differential relay during the charging of transformer. We have discussed all this one. So it is biased. The relay restraining coil is biased with the second harmonic, because this component is very large in magnetic inrush currents, from 30% to 70%. So we provide additional restraining force by passing this second harmonic component through the restraining coil of the differential relay. Understand? So here the directional element connections of directional overcurrent relay are popularly described in terms of angle by which the unit power factor balanced load current flowing in tripping direction leads the voltage applied to the relay potential coil. The protection scheme having the following potential coil and current coil connection is termed as which connection? Thing. In a differential relay, the current is fed from the same phase, but the voltage is fed from other different phases to avoid dead zone problem. Suppose if you take an A phase means R phase, the CT coil is provided with the same coil current, whereas the PT is provided from some other coils. Understand? So here, this is the differential relay. Here the current is fed from the same coil. The voltages are fed from the other coil. So what is the type of connection is asked? Understand? So what is the current IA? Voltage is fed from AC. Very easily we can find out if you draw the phasor diagram. Okay. A, this voltage, the other voltage is being fed from. So this connection is going and getting connected to C phase. So this is A phase, B phase and C phase. This is the connection. So current is through IA, voltage is AC. If you draw the phasor diagram, suppose this is VA, VB and VC. So VAC is required, VA minus VC. So for that what we need to do, if we write minus VC, this will become what? This is minus VC. And if we add these two, what you're going to get? If we add these two, so your VAC will be this. This is your VAC. Okay. How would be IA current? IA current will be in phase with VA because relay only offers resistance. So your IA current will be like this. So the type of connection depends upon the angle between the current and voltage in that particular differential relay. Here you can see what is the angle between the IA and VAC. It is 30 degrees. Why? Because this is 180. This total is 180 if you can recollect. And so 180 means this angle will is 120. So this should be 60. So out of 60, it is bifurcating into half. So angle would be 30 degrees. So the type of connection is a 30 degree connection. Very easily, you have to just find out the angle between the CT current and the PT voltage. So here PT voltage is VAC, CT current is IA. So from the simple phasor diagram, we'll get the angle between them. That is the angle between the relay current and relay voltage, that is 30 degrees. So it is a 30 degree connection. So the next question is, reactance relay is most suitable for the protection of short transmission line because the operation of reactance relay is independent of the arc fault resistance. This is arc fault resistance. So here the answer is exactly true. Yes, reactance relay is used for short transmission line because its operation is independent of resistance. And why? Because the operation of reactance relay is independent of arc fault resistance. Because arc is purely resistive, short transmission lines, there is a more probabilities of arcing. So both A and R true, assertion and reason are true, and R is the correct explanation for A. This is the right answer. Both assertion and reason are true, and a reason is the correct explanation for the assertion. Okay. So the next last topic which I want to tell in the release is the power line carrier communication. The short form is called PLCC, power line carrier communication. I simply want to tell you why we go for this power line communication. There are three main reasons why we go for PLCC. So in PLCC, what happens? The same transmission line, the high voltage transmission line connecting between the two substations is used to send telephone signals, telecommunication signals. Understand? So PLCC uses the same high voltage transmission lines connecting between two substations for telecommunication purpose. Okay. So basically it uses it for transmitting speech and for sending tripping commands okay, to transmit speech data as well as to send the tripping commands. Understand? The voice or data are mixed with radio frequency carrier in the range of 40 to 500 kilohertz and amplified to a level of 10 to 80 watt radio frequency power is injected into the high voltage transmission line by using suitable coupling capacitor. What they do is they convert the data or the signal into radio frequency signals and they transmit through the same transmission. So this is how a PLCC communication occurs. Suppose this is station A and station B, you can observe. So this is one bus bar and this is one bus bar. Okay, this is the circuit breaker or relay, you can say circuit breaker A and circuit breaker B, which is protecting the circuit breaker 1 and circuit breaker 2. Which are protecting this transmission line. Okay, so now these are the main devices that mainly we use are the line trap, which is present at the either end, coupling capacitors. Second important is the coupling capacitors, and the third one is the line tuner. They both are present at the both sides after the circuit breaker. Understand? So here are the relays that are used for protection. Suppose what happens is that line trap or wave trap is the parallel LC filter or band stop filter connected in series with the transmission line. It offers high impedance to carrier signal frequencies and very low impedance to power frequency. So here the normal line trap, what is the function of line trap? The line trap do not allow communication signals entering into substation because it offers very high impedance for the high frequency signals, and it offers very small resistance to our power signals which are at 50 hertz. Okay, so this line trap will not allow the communication signals to enter into substation. Okay, so if suppose some communication signal you are sending in this line, say communication signal you are sending. So this signal, after reaching this end, it will not enter. Line trap will not allow to enter. So communication signal after traveling through the transmission line, it will go into this coupling capacitor. And then to the line tuner, and then through the coaxial cable to the relay or the measurement device. Okay, it will not enter into the substation because this line trap unit will trap and it will guide this into the other path. That is the function of line trap. So here you can see that It is a parallel LC tank filter or a band stop filter connected in series with the transmission line. It offers high impedance to carrier frequency signals. So for communication signals, it offers very high impedance and very low impedance to power frequency, which is 50 hertz. For our power, voltage and current signals, it will offer negligible or zero impedance. So they will directly enter into the substation. But this communication signals, it will trap and guide to the other route. So coupling capacitor, what is the coupling capacitor? This is the coupling capacitor, which I am showing in the image. This is the coupling capacitor. What is its function? So it forms a physical coupling link between transmission line and terminal assemblies for relaying or carrying signals. So it provides high impedance to power frequency and low impedance to carrier signals. So what happens? Line trap will not allow. This will act as a coupler which receives this communication signals and it will send it to the line tuner. Okay. So it is a physical coupling link between the transmission line and the terminal assemblies for relaying of carrier signals. So it is a coupling link between the relay equipment, which is either sending the carrier signals or receiving the carrier signals. Okay, it will offer very high impedance for power frequency and low impedance to signal frequencies. Next one is line tuner. So this is the line tuner. Line tuner is connected in series with coupling capacitor to form a resonant circuit. Okay, its function is to match the impedance of the PLC terminal with power line in order to impress carrier frequency over the power line. In addition, it also provides isolation from power frequency and transient protection. So, okay, what happens is that here the signal is transmitted either by the protective relay. So either you are sending signal or the other thing is that you are receiving signal. So the line tuner is the unit that enables the PLC equipment. Both these are combined are called PLC equipment. So it will enable PLC equipment to send the signal or receive the signal or receive the signal. Understand? So why we use the power line carrier communication? So for protective relaying, we will use, I will tell you example. For telemetry, so it is used to monitor electrical quantities like voltage, current and power at remote locations. What will happen? So we can transmit the voltage, current and power signal through the telephone line by using PLCC for transmitting voice messages. Okay, now see what happens here. If we go again for the distance protection, we know that there is an underreach problem. Suppose this is a transmission line whose length is 200 kilometers. If the fault occurs very close to this point, this relay, so it will not fall in the zone 1 of relay R1. Suppose this is relay R1, this is relay R2. If the fault is occurring at 85% of the length, this is AB. If the fault is occurring after 85%, so what is the zone of relay R1? Zone 1 of relay R1 is only up to 80%. So what happens for this fault? Relay R2 will instantaneously trip. Because it is in zone 1 of relay R2. But there is for relay R1 to trip, there is some time delay. There is some time delay of 0.3 second or something like that. Till then, the fault will continue to exist. The fault current will continue to flow through this path because the relay did not trip. So in this case, to create the trip signal, for relay R1, what happens once there is a fault here? This fault values or trip command is embedded into the by the PLCC. What happens? It will send the trip command to this relay R1, and it will also instantaneously trip. It will also instantaneously trip. Why it is tripping? The trip command is coming from the PLC unit, power line carrier unit here. What happens once this relay trips? It means that there is a fault here. So it has sensed the fault. So then it will immediately embed the same data into the carrier frequency, and it will initiate the trip command to relay R1. So these signals will move in the microseconds. So they are very fast. Within microseconds of tripping of relay R2, the trip command will be activated to relay R1, and relay R1 will also trip without any time delay. So this is how the relaying is established in PLCC. Once relay R2 trips, because the fault is in zone 1, it will immediately send a backup trip command to relay R1, so that it will also instantaneously trip without any time delay. So this is for this kinds of protection we use PLCC. Even in long transmission lines, we cannot implement the differential protection scheme. Why? Because the length of pilot wires become very lengthy. So it is a sort of differential protection where the signal is being transmitted through the radio frequency by the PLC units, power line carrier units. Understand? So with this complete relay protection schemes are over.